Today we are going to start most essential part of our geography syllabus, that is topo sheet. You can check here, I am showing you one topo sheet. Okay, so let's continue with the topo sheet topic. You all know that in your exam question number 1 will be from the topo sheet, okay, which will carry 20 marks, and there will be total 10 questions. Each question carries 2 marks, okay. So this is most essential part of your geography syllabus, okay, which carries 20 marks and it comes in section A, question number 1. Okay, now let's talk about topo sheet in detail. In class 6, 7th, 8th, 9th, you all have done different maps like North America physical map, South Africa physical map, Australia physical map. In class 9th, world physical map, okay? In physical map, in which you show physical features like rivers, mountains, plateaus and plains, okay? There are different types of maps like physical map, political map, topographical maps and so many other types of maps. What are physical maps? In which you show physical part of the surface of the earth, okay? In which you show physical part of the surface of the earth. What are political maps? In which you get information related with different states, different countries, their boundaries, state boundaries, town boundaries, etc. Okay? This is another type of map which is called topo sheet. Now, how this topo sheet is different from other maps? Yes, topo sheet is different from other maps because in topo sheet, we not only show physical features, but of course we show man-made features also. Okay? Topo sheet is a map in which we show physical features as well as man-made feature. Okay? So topographical maps are detailed and accurate graphical representation of features that appear on the surface of the earth, that we represented on a piece of paper, okay, that is called topo sheet. I'm repeating it again. Topo sheet maps are detailed, accurate graphical representation, okay, graphical representation of different features that appear on the earth's surface when those features we represented on a plain paper, that is termed as that. Such maps we call topo sheet. Okay, now how this map is different from other maps? You all know when you will take physical map, you will get boundary of that particular continent or that particular country, and you mark physical features like rivers, plateaus, hills, mountains, so many. Okay, in the same way, when you prepare political map, then you what information you get? Country, main countries boundary, okay, state boundary, town boundary, okay, different boundaries of different states, towns, countries, okay, that you will get. But topo sheet is a map in which you not only get physical features, but of course you get man-made features also. For example, you can check in this topo sheet which I am showing you here. This green color part, obviously it shows forested area, all wooded area, forested area, okay. Different type of forest will be there, okay, but all green color representing forested area. So this is natural feature. This yellow color part which you can see in the topo sheet, okay, yellow color part, wherever you get yellow color, this shows agricultural land, cultivable land, okay. So this is man-made feature, okay, because man produces crop, okay, so this is cultivable land, okay. In the same way, wherever you see white patches in your topo sheet, that represent uncultivable land, okay. So uncultivable land, again natural feature, okay. Wherever you will see red color part, okay, wherever you will see red color, so you can see different red colors are there, these are settlements, okay, human habitants are there, these are settlements area, okay. You can see river is there, river natural feature, red color area settlements, okay, the different settlements are there, they are man-made features, okay, they are man-made features. So you can see in this topo sheet, we are not only getting physical information about the physical features, but of course we are getting information about the man-made features as well. Okay, so topo sheet is a map in which we represent a part of the surface of the earth, any one part which we are going to choose, that we represent on a piece of paper. Okay, that is called topo sheet. Because but one thing is different, that in topo sheet we not only represent physical feature, but of course we represent man-made features. So this is called topo sheet. As I've already given you example here, green color forested area, white patches, uncultivable land. Okay, so this all river, this all comes in category of natural feature. While all red color part, wherever red color is there, that is man-made feature. Okay, wherever yellow color, cultivable land, agriculture land. Okay, agriculture crop produces by human beings, so this is man-made features. Okay, at different places you will get symbol like PO, TO, post office, telegraph office, so that is all man-made feature. So in simple words, topo sheet is a graphical representation of a particular place on the surface of the earth. When that place we represent it on a paper, that is called topo sheet map, in which we not only represent physical features, but of course we represent man-made features also. Okay, I've already given you example. So this is all about topo sheet. Okay, one topo sheet I'm showing you here, one topo sheet you can see here, which I'm showing you. This topo sheet had come in your board exams, okay, in 2018. This is of 2018 topo sheet. Okay, this had come in 2018 in class 10th. You can see this type of topo sheet you will get. Okay, same topo sheet you will get all symbols, all scale, everything will be marked. Okay, so this is the topo sheet of 2018, okay, which had come in 2018 for class 10th board exams. Okay, that time this I'm showing you. So you will also get exactly same type of topo sheet, in which at the bottom symbols will be there, scale will be there, features will be there, okay, easting nothings will be there. So this is all about topo sheet. Now let's talk about the marginal information.